Whippians.
Hey everybody, welcome to 15-4 Challenge Night Thursday.
Hey Jesse!
I just want to be excited like you.
Is everybody ready? Do you have your learning tools out? Stop, look, and listen.
What's wrong with you? Hello, though.
So, we are going to practice with our paradiddles. Do you want to explain what 54 is? Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on.
Hi, guys.
Giggly water.
Don't stop. Hey guys, welcome to the 15-4 challenge, where we are challenging you, as well as ourselves, to learn something new. All you have to do is pick a skill set. Drumming, dancing, woodworking, jewelry making, anything under the sun. All you have to do is practice that skill set for 15 minutes a day, 4 days a week. And we record this live Monday through Thursday at 7 p.m. And if you don't catch us at 7 p.m., you can locate these videos through our website, www.travelsuitproject.com.
So we're going to start off with paradiddles, unless you're painting.
And then they're going to be painted diddles.
I just love that one. Ready to practice our finger rolls?
Yes.
Maybe we should explain what Sharon Miller mentioned in our
Oh yes. Sharon Miller had made a very good point. And Sharon had learned frame drumming from Lane Redman, who was an amazingly wonderful woman who has done lots of fucking amazing drumming things for women in particular. So if you don't know who she is, you definitely need to look her up. But Lane would teach, the notation that she would teach for finger rolls is that each finger is numbered, with your thumb being 1 and your pinky being 5. So we're going to practice our finger rolls, and we're going to do both hands, right?
Yeah.
And we're practicing them on both hands. So when you do a finger roll, you're going to start with finger number 4 on your dominant hand, and we're going fairly slow because I am horrible at this as I'm just starting to play this kind of drum. So we're going to hit, starting with the ring finger, 4, 3, 2. And then with the do the same thing with the non-dominant hand. 4, 3, 2.
Ready?
Yes.
Oh, I guess we're gonna
do that. Your best.
Cup.
So every night after we're done drumming, if we watch TV, which is actually kind of a rarity for us to do after we're done drumming, but last night we're watching TV after we're done drumming, and I have a tendency, if I'm watching TV, I'll like practice the stuff I was drumming on, like on the couch. And Jesse had pointed out that I was lifting my hand away from the drum when I was practicing my finger rolls. And in reality, if you're drumming, you're not going to lift your hand in a weird, off the drum, awkward way to do your finger rolls. You're gonna leave your hand right where it is. And so I just happened to remember that about a minute ago as we're doing our finger rolls. And then I left my hand where it was, and I could actually hear my finger rolls much better than I could doing it this way, because I guess it's kind of improper.
Well, I mean, you're not lifting your hand for your cow, so why would you lift your hand for your chest?
I do lift my hand for my cow.
You come out for your, when you do your finger hand rolls when you're not.
Oh, no, yeah, I know, yeah.
That's so why would you do it for the cow?
Because I don't know what it is. It's probably your fault. Smarty. Something. Why would you do
it
right?
Say it.
gonna start laughing.
Shift to tell you. Let's just do shift.
Shift to tell you.
No, just shift. Just shift. Okay, so play me all three versions of Monsoon. This is your Thursday test. Four cycles of each. Ready, go. Centered around the bases for the rhythms. What could you change in Monsoon to make a new variation of Monsoon?
You mean as far as just the bases go, or just at all?
Not at all. I mean, you have to keep the bases, because that's what makes Muxu Muxu.
So, finger roll and a digitata. Finger roll and a digitata.
A digitata?
Yeah.
You can take the first Muxu and put a bridge on it, which is the... It doesn't have a bridge on it.
No, it
doesn't. So
it's just kind of like the finger before my bridge.
That's fine. Well, these are the things about the different sounds that you can make as far as the pop or for the roll or the grab. But these are all the types of things that you can do to different strokes for different rhythms. What are you doing?
Fun.
So when you're playing the Muxum, it's by learning the different things that you can do on the drum, whether it's a pop or a roll or a finger roll, you have to figure out where you can put them in each rhythm that you learn to make more variations of that rhythm. This way you're not just going... So remember, for your ka, nice ducks.
Ka!
You got your face, your tongue, your ka, your pop.
My duck wanted a kiss!
Your finger roll.
Yeah, I kiss my duck. Very offended. What do you call that? What do you call that? But it's ski?
You call that drum fisting.
That was so dirty.
That's the way how you take it.
Well, how else could that be?
Wasn't this a fist pump?
Yeah.
So this is a...
You didn't put the pump on there. Okay, guys. We'll see you guys on Monday.
See you on Monday. We're going to learn a new rhythm.
A new rhythm on Monday.
And she's going to pick it.
I'm going to pick it?
Yep. So have a good weekend, don't forget to practice, and we'll see you then.